said and done today would bring you honor and glory. Forgive us where we fail. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Into the book of Psalm, chapter 78. Psalm chapter 78, a couple weeks ago, TJ was teaching Sunday school, and he brought this chapter into play. And one thing that kind of caught my eye is that, first of all, the chapter kind of deals with what happened, you know, with the Israelites when they were, you know, in the wilderness, and how they kind of murmured against God and against Moses, and so one thing that kind of caught my eye were these two verses. In verse 40 of chapter 78 of Psalms, it says, "How oft did they provoke him in the wilderness and grieve him in the desert? Yea, they turned back and tempted God and limited the Holy One of Israel." And so onward it tells, "They remembered not his hand, nor the day when he delivered them from the enemy, how he had wrought his signs in Egypt, and his wonders in the field of Zoan, and had turned their rivers into blood and their floods, and they could not drink. He sent diverse sorts of flies among them which devoured them, and frogs which destroyed them. He gave also their increase unto the caterpillar, and their labor unto the locust. He destroyed their vines with hail and their sycamore trees with frost," and so on. And so they didn't want to remember these things. And it says they turned back and tempted God and limited the Holy One of Israel. And there were several thoughts that kind of came to me, you know, through the years, how some people, you know, try to add on to what they think that God needs, instead of having instead of being led of what where God is trying to lead them. The Catholic Church, for instance, they seem to think that God needs a place of purgatory, or they think that God needs such things as Mariolatry, where Mary is the mother of God, or they think that God needs this, when it's really not, you know, humanity's decision of what God needs. They put God, you know, in their pocket. And they put God in a slot. God is everywhere. God is he puts us in, you know, where he needs us to be. We don't need to put God on a shelf. There's no way that you can put God on a shelf. And there's a lot of people who try to tempt God and saying, "Well, you know, God, if you do this for me, I'll do this for you." We ought to have God lead in everything that we do. God is our life. Through Jesus Christ, who is our life everlasting, we ought to do anything that he needs us to do. And so It says they turned back and tempted God and limited the Holy One of Israel. There's a lot of people who limit God in anything that he does. Limiting God, we are so finite in our thoughts and our brains, in our thinking, in our knowledge, in our wisdom. We need God to give us the wisdom and the knowledge. And so, we can't limit God. Let's stand. Brother Clifford, would you dismiss us to our houses?
Most time, Rest and Father, Lord, thank you again, Father, for the opportunity for freedom that we have to be here this morning. Thank you, Father.